Hello, and welcome to the introductory video for Skype for Business 2016. Microsoft has rebranded its link communication tool to Skype for Business. Skype for Business has new icons and slightly different look. Skype for Business also supports video calling. In this video, you will learn how to contact presence and instant messaging, audio setup and making calls, meetings, sharing and collaborating, and about video. Presence is automatically set based on your Outlook calendar. Presence status is a quick way for other people to see whether or not you're free to chat. Here are the presence settings and what they mean. You will notice that available or in green means that you're available and online. Busy and do not disturb basically mean that you are working and you'd prefer not to receive instant messages. Be right back, off work, and appear away is if you're simply not at your computer, whether it's for a short time or a long period of time. You'll also notice other statuses here that you can put in, such as teleworking, department meeting, or interviewing. One other one that you currently do not see here is out of office. That comes directly from Outlook Calendar when you're not there. Finding someone online is easy. Simply type a name in the search box, as soon as you do, the tabs below the search field change to show My Contacts. Once you find a person, add them to your contact list. Right-click the name in the search results. Click Add to Contact List. And pick a group to add your contact to. Set up a group for each team you work with so you can quickly see who's available, or you can also communicate with the entire team at once. Click the Add a Contact button, select Create New Group, and now you can put in the name of that group. You can use instant messaging to touch base with your contacts quickly. In your contact list, point to the contact that you want to send an instant message to. If you want to IM more than one contact, simply hold down the control key and click each contact's name that you want to add to the IM window. And simply double click. Now I can simply send in a message and hit Enter on my keyboard. If you have several conversations or meetings going on at the same time, Skype displays them all in one place, so you can toggle between them. Click a tab on the left to view an IM conversation. Skype automatically saves your IM conversation history. To view or continue a previous conversation or see an IM request you missed, click the Conversation tab, click All or Missed, then simply double-click the conversation that you want to open. If you don't see the conversation you're looking for, go to the bottom to view more in Outlook. Before making an audio call, you're going to want to set up your audio device and check the quality. You can use your computer's mic and speakers, or you can plug in a headset. Click Select your primary device in the lower left-hand corner of the main Skype window. Click Audio Device Settings. Pick your device from the Audio Device menu and adjust the speaker and mic volume. Then click OK. Making a call in Skype is pretty easy. First, you want to find a person that you want to call. Right-click on their name, go down to Call, and Skype Call. It may take a few seconds. And now we're connected. Hi, Becky. Thank you for testing this with us. And now, when I'm done with the call, all I need to do is hang up. Bye. When someone calls you, an alert pops up in the lower right hand of your screen. To answer the call, click anywhere on the photo. Hi, Adise. Thank you so much for testing this with me. And to hang up, I simply click on the red circle. During a call, point to the buttons to do the following. To add video, click on the video call. To mute your audio, select mute my mic. Obviously, to unmute it, select it again. To share a presentation, which we'll be talking about in a few minutes, you click on the present button. And to hang up, click the phone button in the conversation window. To schedule a Skype for Business meeting, you need to go to your Outlook calendar, click the Home tab, go to New Items, and go down to Skype Meeting. Complete the meeting request just like you normally would. And of course, put in the date and time. Once your colleagues receive this email, they can click on Join Skype Meeting to join at this particular time. Now, when I send it, I will receive a reminder about this meeting and notice that it allows me to join online. Once I click Join Online, I receive a Join Meeting audio where I can select if I want to use Skype for Business audio and video to connect, if I want the system to call me at a specific number, or if I don't want to use audio at all. I will be using Skype for Business audio and video. Now I'm part of the meeting. I'm the only one here, but I'm part of the meeting. If I want to click on video, I can also have a video option as well for this. And now I can simply hang up. If you're in a Skype meeting and you need to show everyone what you're talking about, please do the following. In the meeting window, click the present button and then go up to present desktop if you want to show everyone your desktop. In addition, you can also present a specific program, or you can present a PowerPoint presentation. It's easy to capture audio, video, IM, and what's being presented. In the meeting window, click the More options and go up to Start Recording. You'll notice at the bottom it says recording has started. After the meeting, go to Manage Recordings to publish, play, rename, or delete the recording. If a meeting gets unruly and you need to take back control, click the Participants button to open a participant pane. This way you can see a list of everyone in the meeting. Click the Participants Action button and select one or more multiple buttons to take away items or give back things to the participants. You can allow others to flip through slides, contribute information, and make changes to a whiteboard or OneNote, PowerPoint, or any other kind of file, or demonstrate a program with just a couple of clicks. You are still able to take back control at any time. The simplest way to share a file is to drag and drop either to the instant message area or to the participant's name. If you need to show what you're talking about, draw it using the whiteboard. In the conversation window, click the Present button, click More, and select Whiteboard. It will take a second or two to launch. You will notice that there's a tool set on the right-hand side, and it even has a laser pointer. Before you can do any video call, you want to make sure that your settings are correct. Go to the top and click on your settings, which will display your Skype for Business options. On the left-hand side, you want to select video device. If you see yourself, you're pretty much set. If you don't, you want to make sure that you select the correct camera from the top video device selection. To start a video call, select the contact that you want to start a video call with, right-click, and select Start a Video Call. Once you do that, the other person gets a pop-up screen asking them if they want to accept your call. And at any time during your call, if you want to stop showing video, click the video button again. You can start on-the-spot video meeting anytime. If people are available, you can bring them into a meeting now instead of scheduling one for later. In your contact list, basically select the individuals that you want to have in the meeting by holding down the control key on your keyboard and selecting the individuals. Then you simply have to right-click and start a video call. This concludes our Skype for Business 2016 video. Please keep checking the LMS training schedule to see when new Skype for Business 2016-led classes will be offered. Also, by following the link below, you can request additional assistance. Thank you for watching.